All news, all the time. Southern California's only all news radio station.
Well, you may have been hearing the buzz that the new operating system for iPhones and iPads could make people dizzy and sick. Apparently, it really is a thing you have to worry about. Dr. Jennifer Dearberry is a nationally recognized expert on vertigo and dizziness at St. Vincent Medical Center's House Clinic.
For some people, they are experiencing dizziness, and if they also have migraines, they're getting in classic migraine headaches and the whole aura and the one-sided pain and in some cases vomiting, world spinning around.
Now, doctor, have you actually looked at the screen of the new operating system yourself to see what the problem might be?
I sure did. I went out to one of the Apple stores because I'd been getting reports. I was curious about it. I haven't upgraded my phone. I don't think I'm going to the new operating system. And it's interesting. You know, if you don't have dizziness or migraines, it's kind of cool in a way. But if you do, what happens is you're standing still. And as you're looking at the phone, the background is moving with the phone, you know, the background of whatever they put in. If you angle the phone, the pixels appear to be moving around. And what's happening is, for sensitive individuals, the brain is getting information that you're standing still. But the eyes are telling the brain, no, I'm moving. There's all this movement because it's looking at the phone. And when the brain gets a mismatch and doesn't know how to interpret confusing data, you get dizzy, you get vertigo, spinning sensations.
Doctor, is it fair to say, I've noticed this myself, and tell me if this is a fair correlation to what you just said. I'm at a stoplight, and my car is stopped, and all of a sudden, possibly the car beside me starts rolling one way or the other, and I check my brake to make sure I'm stopped, because I feel like I might be moving.
Well, you need to come and see us in the office, it sounds like. No, you're absolutely, that's a perfect example of a brain-eye mismatch, perfect example, because you're sitting still, but your eye to the side detected movement. And told the brain there's movement, but, you know, your butt isn't moving off the car seat, The brain doesn't know what to do.
That, again, is Dr. Jennifer Dearberry, a vertigo expert with St. Vincent Medical Center's House Clinic. Now, if you have a new phone, you can choose a reduce motion option on the iOS 7. It's right there hiding in the acceptability menu.